blikken, blikken, blikken. Blikken, 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 blikken. Blikken, 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 blikken.
Yo, what's up world? It's your boy Filotico here. And today, we're gonna have another cool lesson on something dealing with girls. You know me, that American dude with the incredible mood. So you know I'm gonna give you an awesome lesson. Now, I just came back to Russia, because right now I'm in Russia. Before this, I was in New York City. So what I'm gonna teach you is about the type of women we have out there. And depending on the type of woman you may get as your girlfriend, she might fit in one of these five categories. But there's like another 10 categories, but I'm only gonna give you 5 in this video because I don't wanna give you 15 because that will definitely take too long. So let's get to these 5 types of girlfriends that you could probably meet in New York City. So let's get to it. The first and pretty new commonly used slang term for this type of girlfriend is the ratchet girlfriend. Well, I can explain it, but it is much better for me to just show you a video.
Oh.
See, now that girl is ratchet. What makes her ratchet? She's loud, she's disrespectful, she's likely to be violent, you know, she only cares about herself, she's very selfish. So you definitely do not want a ratchet girlfriend. Ratchet girlfriends are known for when they get older, they have like a lot of kids by different men, and they're not usually pretty because they don't take care of themselves that much. So ratchet girlfriends, yeah, you want to stay away from them. Usually ratchet girlfriends are very loud and disrespectful. So if you want a girl who's not ratchet, odds are if she's loud, stay away from her. If she's quiet and she's calm and, you know, she seems very polite, odds are you won't be dealing with a ratchet chick. So you won't have to worry about it. That's the first one. Ratchet. Stay away from them. Let's get to the second type of girlfriend you might find out in New York. The second type is the clingy girlfriend. Now, the clingy girl, yeah, the picture says it all right. The clingy girlfriend is the kind of girlfriend who just will not leave your side. She does not give you a moment of privacy. She is always there. The clingy girlfriend, hey, it may seem pretty cool at first, but when sometimes you may feel you need some time to be alone, to think, or be with your friends, she does not like it if she's not there. She is very clingy. And the word cling basically means to hold on or to hang on to something. And when she's clingy, she's always next to you or she always tries to be next to you. So you can't even go see your mother on her birthday by yourself without her being there. Some guys can't even use the bathroom without her being there. You can't even go to jail by yourself. She'll be right next to you screaming, "I did it too!" That is a clingy girlfriend. Now the reason why clingy girlfriends aren't good is because there's some things we all need to do alone. We all need alone time, we all need to be able to think, and we all need to do some things for ourselves. It's very important. So having a clingy girlfriend isn't as bad as having a ratchet girlfriend, but it is a little weird. Yeah, you can tell just by the way she looks, she's clingy. Baby, what are you doing here? Clingy. Celebrating. Clingy. Next one. Next type of girlfriend is the walkover. Now the walkover girlfriend is the kind of girl who does everything you say whenever you tell her to do it, and she doesn't care about what you're doing when you're in privacy because you can walk over her. First thing you need to understand is, what does it mean to walk over somebody? When you walk over someone, that means you can basically control them and do what you want. The walkover girlfriend most likely has low self-esteem. So she probably thinks she's not pretty, she thinks she's not smart, she thinks she smells bad. Everything she thinks about herself is bad, and that's why she would do anything you say because she feels she can't get anyone else. She has low self-esteem. That means she doesn't think there's so many things great about her. So it may seem cool to have a girlfriend to walk over, but it's very disrespectful to her because you're helping her to believe that she's a nobody. And the biggest problem with walkover girlfriends is that a lot of guys get used to this kind of behavior. So they could tell her things like, shut up, or do this, do that. And when they get a new girlfriend who's not a walkover, they try to tell her to shut up, and next thing you know, shut up, bitch. Now if a girlfriend hits you for saying something like that, she is not a walkover. But if she goes, yes sir, odds are she's a walkover. So let's get to the fourth one. And the fourth one we're going to learn for today is the whiner. Now, what does it mean to whine? To whine means to complain. to constantly complain that things are not good enough. That is the whining girlfriend. For example, baby, you didn't give me enough money to go shopping. Baby, you don't give me enough attention. Baby, you watch Filosco's videos way too much. Baby, we've been dating for 2 weeks already and we're still not married. Baby, our house, which only me and you live in, only has 10 bedrooms, but I want 30 bedrooms. Baby, that is the whiner. She complains about things all the time and even complains about things she shouldn't be complaining about. Whining girlfriends need constant attention. Constant attention. You can't even look at another girl because then she'll feel bad and she'll be like, are you looking at other girls? Why are you looking at her? That's my sister. I'm just making sure it's my sister. I don't care. That's kind of like what the whining girlfriend does. She complains about everything because nothing's ever good enough and she always thinks you're doing something and what you should be doing more, okay? That is the whining kind of girlfriend. Be careful of those, okay? Now let's get to the fifth and last one for today. Now the fifth and last one is generally new. So I went back to America like 2 months ago when I went back to New York. I heard people saying this and I didn't understand it because I was in Russia for so long. So I was like, what the hell is a thot? A thot, T-H-O-T. What is a thot? Well, a thot is a new Ebonics word that a lot of people are using. And what it stands for is that hoe over there. But what does it actually mean? Well, a thot actually means a girl that's average. She's completely average. There's nothing special about her. And she usually has a bunch of boyfriends. So for example, let's say I had a new girlfriend and she was a thot, but I didn't know she was a thot, right? And I'm like, yo guys, look at my new girlfriend. It's so cool, isn't she great? So one of my friends would say, hey Phil, come here for a minute. I'm like, yeah man, what's up? And he would say something like, dude, she's a thot. She's completely normal. I don't know why you're so happy. And plus, she has a lot of boyfriends. That is a thot, okay? So let's say a girl is really, really beautiful and she has a lot of boyfriends. Well, she's not necessarily a thot. In that case, she's just known as a hoe if she has a lot of boyfriends or she has, you know, private time with a lot of men, but she looks really good. She is a hoe in that case. But a woman who looks average and, you know, she gets with a lot of men, then she's a thot. She's an average girl who's not special, who has a lot of boyfriends. That is known as that hoe over there. Now, the word thot, you really don't want to use this in any sort of formal setting. It's a very informal word. It is Ebonics, but it is very popular now. You can look it up on the internet. You can hear people using it all the time. So that is a thot. A thot is that hoe over there. She's average and has a lot of boyfriends. So that's our five for today, people. You know what that means. And so that's the end of the episode for today. I hope you liked it. I hope you enjoyed it. And I hope you learned new stuff. Be sure to add me, vk.com/philosophical. That's me, and subscribe to my YouTube page, see all my videos. And right now I'm in Yekaterinburg. I'm about to have some classes here in Yekaterinburg. I know I can't say it. I'm gonna have about 6 classes here, so if you like to come to the classes in Yekaterinburg, please check the links in the description. And after this, I'll be in Moscow, Tula, Lipetsk, and maybe some more to add. So if you wanna get me in your city, contact me on VK, and if you wanna come to the class, check the description. And that's basically it, people. You know what the guy says at the end of the video.
And don't be racist.
So don't be that is his catchphrase.